welcome in to the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. I'm Timonel Abrams, along with my grandson, Zachary Thomas Abrams, and we are at Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega, Alabama for the start of the season for the Talladega Tigers. Game two for the Munford Lions. Munford beaten last week by Oxford 48-6 in Talladega, their first game of the season. And Zach, good to have you with us tonight. You ready to go?
Yes, I am ready to go.
All right.
And I hope I do a good job on my first time on the pregame show.
Well, the pay's the same. You'll do good, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, where do you go to school?
Well, I go to school at Pinecrest Elementary.
In Sylacauga, right?
Yes.
What grade you in?
Fourth.
All right. You got a girlfriend?
I don't want to mention that
on
TV.
All right. Hey, we got our first local game of the season tonight, Munford and Talladega. Talladega playoff team last year, and new coach Shannon Felder. And Coach Felder came in late in the fall, and actually in summer camp almost, and it's late July, and he took over. And so it's his first game as head coach for the Talladega Tigers. And Michael Easley in his second contest as head coach of the Munford Lions. Munford beaten by a strong Oxford team last week by a score of 48-6. The Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week, also brought to you by State Representative Ron Johnson, Marble City Pharmacy, Sylacauga Glass, B.B. Comer Booster Club, Cindy Pennington, and the Greater Coos Valley Area Chamber of Commerce, along with Stop and Shop Auto Sales, Lori Darling Restaurant in Fayetteville, and Omnia, also a part of our high school coverage tonight. And Zach, these guys got to be nervous, especially with Talladega. It's our first game of the year, kind of like your first broadcast.
Yes, I think that it's going to be a good match. And Munford, I think that they could have the advantage here since they have played already their first game of the season.
That's a good point. And we'll see what Talladega does. You know, Talladega's got a guy by the name of Nigel Scales, and he's their quarterback, and he runs and throws, and he's got all kind of accolades already bestowed upon him. So he's a good player for Talladega, but it's their first game of the year. You know how the first game jitters are sometimes?
Yes, like I am very nervous right now.
You'll be all right.
But I think Talladega should be very nervous.
You know, Talladega won the basketball state championship.
They did.
And so Talladega's football team made the playoffs last year. And Coach Chucky Miller, the athletic director there, and they are trying to pick up the pace a little bit at Talladega High School as the Tigers take on the Munford Lions tonight. And that is our game of the week presented by Donahue Physical Therapy. Munford just up the road, probably about, maybe 8 miles or so difference in towns, Munford and Talladega. And they know each other real well. It's kind of like when you go to school.
Yeah.
You know kids that go to school with you and that go to church with you, stuff like that. It's kind of like these guys.
I have one girl who's in my class this year and goes to church with me too.
See, so it's a small world after all, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, we've got Gerhard Methangani coming up with the Pigskin Roundup preview, and that roundup comes tonight after our game. So you'll want to stick around for that, and we'll have all the scores from around the area and highlights and interviews and all that kind of stuff too. So you don't want to miss that tonight after our high school football game. Let's catch up with Gerhard as he takes a look at some of the other matchups tonight.
Welcome into our Pigskin Roundup studios, getting ready for a huge Pigskin Roundup show, wrapping up everything in week one of the high school football season. We have a few games on tap that we love to talk about. Our game of the week, we'll also talk about one of the other big time games is White Plains and Ohatchee. Of course, White Plains coming off a huge win last week. They won our KFC Pigskin Roundup Team of the Week after a 42-12 victory over Vincent. They'll now take on Ohatchee. Ohatchee playing their first game of the season, but they do have a big dominant running back in Dominique Thomas. White Plains knows that this could be a statement game for them. Ohatchee knows that every game this season will be huge for the Indians.
Ohatchee, great opponent. Coach Martin's a great coach. They got a great team. They've been to the quarterfinals last year, and expect them to make a big run again this year. Just an awesome experience for us to be able to match up with somebody like that this early in the year, see where we're at, kind of have a measuring stick, and we're excited about the challenge. We know that they're good, but we also believe in what we do and what we got put in, and we believe in our offense and our defense and our special teams, and we believe our guys are going to come out and play Friday night.
As a coach, we temperament. It's a week-to-week-to-week-to-week basis. And these young men will tell you, regardless of whether we're playing Fife in the quarterfinals or we're playing somebody on our schedule that hadn't won one or two games, each week is treated the same because each week is just as equally important. We know that when we step on the football field, we're going to get the best effort out of whoever we play every time.
Should be some great games, and we will cover them all for you. We'll have the scores of all of our local games, area highlights, including our game of the week, one we just talked about with Alexandria and number 5 Jacksonville, two Calhoun County rivals hooking up. We will also have cameras making pit stops at Hoke's Bluff, Oxford, Lincoln, Gaston, Spring Garden, and several other spots. Hoke's Bluff head coach Mike Robertson and Sacks head coach Jonathan Miller will both join us in studio. Also, be sure to like our page on Facebook and follow us on Twitter by searching Pigskin Roundup. Also, remember, you can watch the show live online, streaming there at TV24.tv, also right here on TV24 and on TV47. That's it for us here at the Pigskin Roundup studio. We'll see you in a little bit.
All right, Gerhard, thanks a lot. And we got lots to tell you about tonight as we get set for Talladega and Munford. And my grandson, Zach Abrams, getting his first opportunity to be on TV, and he's going to be a sportscaster one day, so he'll make a good one too, right?
I hope so.
Yeah.
I and also considered playing in the NFL or playing in the NBA.
You want to play for the Browns?
Browns?
Yeah.
I mean, the only two players I like on their team is OBJ and Baker Mayfield.
Ah, okay.
And Myles Garrett.
All right, you want to go ahead and make your pick for this game, or are you just going to wait and see how it works?
I'll make my pick because I think that the Munford Lions will take this game because they have the advantage, like I said before, because they have already played one game in the season.
They'll have to pick it up because Talladega's got a lot of great athletes on this team.
They do.
All right, and we'll catch up with you a little bit later on. Appreciate you being with me tonight, okay?
Thank you very much.
All right. All right. Hey, we caught up with Coach Shannon Felder as the media day just a few weeks ago, and he was introduced as the head football coach at Talladega High School.
Coach, welcome to Talladega. But talk about the last few days. I know it's been a busy few days, and you got to hit the ground running. Just talk about how everything's been going.
Well, it's definitely been a busy time. Like I said, got voted in Tuesday and met with the guys and done a few things yesterday and basically done the same thing again today. So it was been a quick turnaround, but we've hit the ground running and hopefully we can get things going and, you know, familiarize myself with the players, with the community and with the coaches. So it's been a busy time.
Coach, how much of your, I guess, philosophy and offense thesis and schemes can you get installed in such a short time when you have to take the schemes that have been around and have them build in with those?
Well, we're putting our system in. We're just kind of translating their terminology to our terminology. You know, we may call one route one thing and they called it something else. So we're trying to teach them, you know, our system. And we're going to try to do 3 or 4 plays a day with the terminology, and it's going to be a process, but it's necessary to put our system in because, you know, trying to learn their system, at some point it's going to end up hurting us. So we want to make sure that we're doing the things that we're familiar with, teaching those things to the guys. We're going to move at a pace, you know, that at whatever pace that they allow us, their learning curve allows us to do. But we're going to put our stuff in, and we put a little bit at a time, and we'll probably be putting some stuff in even as the season goes on.
Coach, there are a few coaches that have gone through what you're going through right now. and that's having to come in and take over on such a short notice and play in a matter of a month. Can you talk about, really, for those of us that aren't coaches, that don't know what that's like, can you give us an idea of just how hard it is?
Well, again, you know, I got the job Tuesday. We were putting a plan together Tuesday as far as, you know, how we were going to implement our offensive system, defensive system, what we were going to try to get done on a day-to-day basis. You know, one of the things I told the guys is that the fans don't care if I got hired an hour before the first game. The only thing they're going to care about at the end of the day is, you know, that we win. Are we going to make the playoffs? So, you know, we've got a plan together. We're going to work the plan, and it won't be any excuses at the end of the season.
For the players, I mean, to just talk about how everything's been going. It's got to hit the ground. You got to learn different things. But to just talk about how the last few weeks went for you guys.
Last few weeks have been, it's just been crazy, for real. Like, we... Just as much as the coaches, they've been through stuff, we've been through stuff, learning new stuff. We gotta really, like, try to forget some of the stuff and try to put some new stuff in, but it's been a task, and we're handling it very good right now, so I believe we can do it.
Yeah, for everybody who been there before the new coaches came in, Coach Feld and all them, the players, we just need to lock in and just focus, and, like, every day when we go to practice, we need to just focus on learn the new system so we'll be ready for the first game.
We just got to come in every day and work hard and make sure that we learn all these new plays and all the new terminology. We'll be all right.
For the guys' mindset doesn't change. You guys feel hungry and just trying to take that next step, right?
Oh, well, it definitely makes us even more hungry. Like, when he had told you he was leaving, it's like, we know we wanted to stay a little bit, but he said he got to go, so he got to go. So now we have to get on the ground and run. And Coach Felder came in, and now, I mean, we're grateful for Coach Felder, and we're even more hungry than we was before. So now we're ready to get this thing going on.
I mean, being leaders, how did you guys just control everything? You just try to just keep everybody keep on pushing and working hard through it, or?
You still got to have the same mindset. It don't matter, like, what's going on the outside, because we still going to be the only ones playing on Friday night, so it don't matter what's going on with the coaching staff and everything, we still need to focus on what we got to do so we can get it done.
For the players, what's your determination level given what happened with Coach Darby and now having Coach Felder in on such a short notice? You know, the program had kind of turned the corner the last couple of years. You guys have made the playoffs. You've been respectable again. What's the determination level to keep it going in that direction?
I feel like the situation with Coach Darby has been in our review right now. We got to keep on going with Coach Felder, and then our determination level has went up, basically. Like, it's went up to another level. Everybody is hungry in the weight room, working very good in the weight room, working very good in on the practice field. We maxed out this week. Everybody had great maxes. So, I mean, our determination is very well. Like, we're ready for this thing to keep on going. And we're going to be all right.
Coach Felder, you were talking earlier, you kept saying we're putting in our plan, we're putting in our terminology. Did you bring anybody with you from Sumter Central, or are you basically working with the same staff that's in place?
Well, we have basically the same staff that's already been in place. I did bring Paul Farlow with me. Paul Farlow has been coaching with me since I was at Donahoe. And so we've been running the same stuff on offense for a lot of years. So, you know, bringing Paul in is going to help me because, you know, he's going to call the plays on offense. We've always worked together with that stuff. So it allows both of us to, you know, to talk to and help teach the coaches. And then we all teach the players. So it's certainly a positive. You're bringing in another guy with a lot of head coaching experience. You know, we kind of bounce thoughts and ideas off each other. Paul and I put the plan together for what we were going to be doing and how we were going to try to do things based off of his experience and my head coach experience. So we think we've got a pretty good plan for our guys. We've been trying to work that plan. I'm excited to have him. I'm excited to be, to be the coach of these guys. These guys have been working really hard, and like they were saying, they've been through a lot too. You know, for a long time, these guys didn't know who was going to be coaching them. I know that Coach Darby did an excellent job in turning the program around, changing the mindset of the guys, which has also changed the mindset of the community. You know, these guys have made the playoff 2 years in a row. And just like I told them, you know, I asked them, you know, are you satisfied with what you've done? You had a good season last year. You won 5 games. You made the playoffs. You know, do we want to be the team that win 5 games again this year, makes the playoff, or do we want to be hungrier this year? And if that's what we want to do, then we're going to have to work harder than we worked last year, be more focused than we were last year, and be more determined to take that next step.
Where did Coach Farlow, what was his head coaching experience?
Now, Coach Farlow has been the head coach at Lincoln High School. He's the head coach at Weaver for a long time. You know, he's been a very successful head coach and has done a wonderful job.
Coach Felder, I know it's also, like you said, it's a learning curve for the players, but also for you itself, it might be a learning curve because you're familiarizing yourself with these kids. But one advantage it seems like might be out there is the nucleus of this football team. They are also defending state basketball champions. Nigel and DeCorey are part of that success. How does that translate over to the football field? You get some guys with that championship swagger, that mentality, and they're part of that core leading the team.
Well, I mentioned that to the guys a little bit yesterday about the fact that, you know, that he's won a state championship. He knows what it takes to win it. You know, he knows that, and like I told him, I know the basketball team, in order for them to win a state championship, I told him, I said, maybe y'all started the season out not necessarily believing y'all were going to be state champions. And then I said, as the season rolled along, somewhere along the way, y'all start playing some pretty good ball, start buying more off into what the coach was saying, and start believing more. And then that allowed them to stay more focused, more determined, and then, you know, they end up winning the state championship. And that's the same thing for us, you know. It's important we get off to a good start, you know, for the players and for the coaches and for the community. And then I believe as, you know, if we get off to that good start that we need to get off to, then it's only going to build the confidence in the guys to buy into what we're doing and to continue to work hard and continue to stay focused on taking that next step.
Have you got a chance to evaluate your kids? Do you go back and watch film, what they did last year, or how does that process work for you?
Well, I've watched their spring game. I watched the spring game, and because that's the players that are going to actually be back. You know, sometimes you watch the film, you got to kind of keep going back, see who's going, you know, who played last year, what they did, where they played. The spring game gives you a little bit idea of the position that they were anticipating playing going into this season. So we watched a little bit of the film, but you know, we run a different system. So the different system, you know, don't mean that one guy that played one position, they played that position based on the system that they were running last year. So, you know, that don't necessarily mean they'll be running the same thing this year. What we tried to do was watch the film to evaluate the players. You know, what they can actually do, and how would they be able to contribute to what we're trying to do with our system. So, I'm still learning. I mean, you know, I've been on the job 2 days, and still learning the players, still trying to learn the names. I know they be laughing at me sometimes because I call the wrong name. You know, I say the wrong name, but I'm still learning them. I think that they know that you know, I come to work hard. I come to win. I want to make them better players, better young men, better students. You know, my goal is to help them go to the next level athletically as well as academically.
I mean, how do you feel going into a spring event? You're going to be able to show your talent. Just talk about that.
I think the offensive scheme we got right now is going to be great. Like, as far as for me, as far as for Deco, as far as for my receiver core, for Michael, Isaiah Cunningham, John Ellis. We got a lot of talent on the outside. We got a lot of talent as far as backs. So we're gonna be great. The O line is getting better. So we're gonna be a hard to stop offense. We should be really hard to stop this year. So.
I like his confidence. He probably said more than I would say. But I do like. We do have some talent, you know. And I think that we got some good skill players coming back. We've got a line that's inexperienced, You know, that's an area where we really got to make some improvements. But I love this team. I love what I told the guys, you know, we work hard, and that's certainly a tribute to Coach Darby. I mean, I think he done a wonderful job in changing the mindset. And when you change the mindset of the players, then they're more willing to work harder because they've seen results. As they've seen results, it's made them hungrier. These guys are pretty mature. And so even with the changes that they've been through, you know, they need to be commended on the way that they've handled it, you know.
Talk about the region in your schedule a bit, though.
Talk about the region? It's day two. I'm more worried about the players than I am the region. My focus is on trying to learn this team, trying to put the system in, and trying to figure out what we need to do to be successful. So if I can do that, then I'm not really concerned about who we're playing, because if we're not able to play things the way we want to play and get everybody to learn what we want them to learn, then it's not going to be good anyway. So I'm focused on our team.
Coach, how many do you have out this year? Do you even know yet?
Well, right now we probably got about 45 players out there. I anticipate as school starts, we'll get some more people to come out. But I like the guys we have out there. I like our focus right now, and I think these guys are hungry, and I'm excited about it.
Coach, what was it about the Tally program that made you even consider making a change like this close to the season starting?
Well, I mean, I knew that the program was growing. And not necessarily just the football program. The Talladega has consistently had a good basketball team. And, you know, to me, I've been at places that typically, if you have a good basketball team, you have the potential to have a pretty good football team as well. I think that Coach has done an excellent job working with the football coaches. And I'm talking about Coach Chucky, has done an excellent job working with the football players. A lot of programs you get at, if they have a successful basketball team, the basketball coach don't want the boys to play football, and it hurts your program. And it's not that way here. You know, we had a state championship basketball guy, and is also outstanding football player. So with the coaches working together, the program has a much, much better chance of being successful. And I think that's what this program's been doing.
Coach Felder, your predecessor had a mantra that he would echo at these media days. Losing is not an option. He kind of hammered that into these kids. Do you have a similar mantra, or do you have anything that you, like an underlying message that you drive home to these kids every day?
Well, you know, my message is just that, you know, if you want better, then you've got to give more in whatever you're trying to do. You know, I just want these guys to understand that, you know, nothing in life is free. You know, whatever you want, you got to be willing to work for it. You got to be willing to make some sacrifices for it. You got to stay focused and determined on whatever that goal is set for you. So, you know, if we want to be state champions in football, then the way we approach practice, the way we approach going to class, the way we approach going to the weight room will reflect how bad we really want it.
And that's Coach Shannon Felder, who had been on the job 2 days when we had media day in Talladega. And I'm very, very impressed with Coach Felder. And he said he's not worried about the region. He's worried about his kids right now. So he'll do a good job. And we look forward to tonight's matchup. First game under the leadership of Coach Shannon Felder. And he'll be going, his Tigers will be going up against the Munford Lions and first-year coach Michael Easley. And Munford lost last week, and that's no disgrace to lose to Oxford. They lost to Oxford 48-6. And tonight they will get a chance to redeem themselves as they take on the Talladega Tigers at Mary Dumas Stadium. We await our national anthem that is brought to you by Silicaga Glass and Debbie Sanders and Mike Sanders, all the folks there presenting the national anthem. We'll have that coming up shortly. We'll take a quick timeout and be back with the national anthem and kickoff for Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week right after this.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Aux Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good. Things feeling a little uneven at home? Aux Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Aux Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Aux Foundations.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
We are just moments away from the kickoff for Munford and Talladega. Talladega, the first game of the season, Munford 0-1 as we get things going from Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega. We've got the national anthem brought to you by Silicaga Glass Company. We'll head to the field in just a moment for that. We appreciate Donahue Physical Therapy for being our corporate sponsor again this year. And Ben and all the folks at Donahue Physical Therapy wish for all our teams in the area a fantastic season. Also, State Representative Ron Johnson, our District 33 representative, Marble City Pharmacy, Cindy Pennington. She is sponsoring our first downs again this year. So we welcome Cindy back, and Greater Coosa Valley Area Chamber of Commerce and Tom Robertson, folks there. They support our instant replay. So all of that here on the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. Two quarterbacks tonight, Jay Tuck of Munford, and for Talladega, Nigel Scales, and it promises to be a fantastic football game and a nice crowd already gathering at Mary Dumas Stadium for the kickoff. And Munford 0-1, Talladega getting their season started, and you take a look at some of the Talladega team and Munford team as they get set to get this one going. Mary Dumas Stadium has been around a long, long time, and they have done a good job with that stadium. They've kind of renovated some of it, and it's been here many, many years, Mary Dumas Stadium, the Talladega High School Tigers home field. And they're hosting the Munford Lions tonight. Kind of unusual. Munford traveled to Oxford to play last week. They're in Talladega to play this week, so they haven't had a home game, at least through two games this season. And these two teams know a little bit about each other. They played last year, and you know, Ted Darby was the coach at Talladega last year, and he thought that he was getting the job at White Plains, and the Calhoun County Board of Education decided otherwise, and so it kind of left things in limbo a little bit. Darby was let go at Talladega. Shannon Felder, who had put in his application already and really wanted this job, so he was hired to take over as Talladega's head coach. So Scales, DeCorian Wilson, Bobo Swain, Isaiah Cunningham, some of these other guys that have had playing time. You look for them tonight. The Munford Lions kind of rebuilding a little bit. Munford is 5A and Talladega is 4A. And Munford coming off some really good years there in Region 5 in 5A. And Talladega, they are in region play as well. In Class 4A. So we look forward to this one tonight as we get started from Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega. We've got the kickoff coming up. We've got our national anthem brought to you by Silicaga Glass Company coming up as well. Don't forget tonight after the game, it'll be Pigskin Roundup. We'll join our friends at TV24 who's airing this game tonight. We'll partner with them to bring you Pigskin Roundup the second weekend of high school football. It's really the first weekend where we've got all games at the count tonight. So we look forward to that about 10:30 tonight after our coverage here ends with Talladega and Munford. Our national anthem presented by Silicaga Glass Company is next. National anthem provided for us tonight, courtesy of Silicaga Glass Company. You saw the two teams as they head out onto the field. Talladega, the host team, and Munford, the visiting team. You can see Munford brought a lot of fans along the far sideline, and it's not far from Talladega, so you would expect that they are going to bring fans with them, and so. Munford headed out onto the field now. Munford dressed in white with the red headgear. And Talladega dressed in their home red jerseys and white pants and red headgear. This is the first game of the season for the Talladega Tigers. And they're led by the junior Nigel Scales. And he is a good, good athlete. Makes a lot of things happen. Whether he's throwing or running the football. So look forward to seeing him tonight. Hadn't seen him since last year. Talladega made the playoffs last year, and they lose on the road in round one of the 4A playoffs, but it's the first time they made the playoffs in a while. So they're looking forward to getting better and improving, and so is the Munford Lions. Munford in Region 5, and 3-7 last year. They look to improve on that record tonight as Munford will kick off as we get set for the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week from Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega. We appreciate all of you being along with us tonight. And preparing to kick off for Munford is Justin Sistrunk. Both sides of the field is fired up, and we're underway. There's going to be a short kick and fumble around at the 40-yard line. Munford says they've got it. And they do. Munford, I think, has recovered the football. Let's see. I don't know if that was a planned play on the kickoff or not, but it hit in an area where Munford got a lot of people around it. The Lions got an injured player on the opening kickoff. Hopefully he's going to be okay. They're kind of trying to get him up, making sure he's okay. And that is Jaquan Anderson, the injured Munford player. hurt on the opening kickoff. We did not get a signal from the officials who football was, so Munford was very excited. They thought they had it, and now they're going to kick it again, looks like. Nope, Munford did recover the opening kickoff, so they recover the fumble, and they'll have it first down and 10. Now already in Talladega territory at about the 39-yard line. We told you about Tuck. Tuck's a good player. This time he dishes off inside and picking up about 6 yards. And both hands on the football. He's a big running back for Munford. That is Sistrunk. He picked up about 5. It'll be second down and 5. Jay Tuck, the quarterback. Tuck gives it to Sistrunk again. This time he's spun down. Nice defensive play over there is Cordarius Montgomery for Talladega. So it'll be third down now. Montgomery is a linebacker. He makes a stop. So we'll bring up third down now for the Munford Lions. Third and long. See, Tuck tries to throw it or he leaves it again to the big running back, and he's got the first down. That's Sistrunk again. Sistrunk's inside the 30-yard line to about the 27. Another tackle by Montgomery. And that's a Greater Coosa Valley Area Chamber of Commerce instant replay. And you see this Sistrunk, he just goes north and south. So it's first down for the Lions. After recovering the opening kickoff. Here's Sistrunk again. He pounds inside the 25 to the 20-yard line. Big, big holes for the running back to get through. So Munford is having their way. Just running it right at Talladega. Second down and about 3. Just underway. Munford recovered the fumble on the opening kickoff. Not much yardage there for Parker. Excuse me, that is Corbin Smith, excuse me, on the carry. I bring up third down now and still about 3. So Talladega wants to make a stop here as Jay Tuck gets the play from Michael Easley along the sideline. Sistrunk on the right side with him. Sistrunk's been having the bulk of the carry. And they go back to Smith, and Smith is knocked down. Good defensive play by Talladega. Circling around, that's C.J. White, the linebacker. It's fourth down now. And may have lost maybe a yard or two, so. So fourth down, and about 8 now. Tuck has not thrown it a time. Let's see if he does it. Here he looks. Throws across the middle, got a man wide open inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. Kicks made by Tadarius Parker. It will be a Munford first down. Greater Coosa Valley Area Chamber of Commerce. It's the replay. And you can see that nice throw by Tuck. And a great catch by Parker. It'll be a first down. So Munford keeps the drive alive. Tuck looking in the end zone. Now flips it, it's incomplete. Had two guys in the same area, and Sistrunk got his hands on it, but that wasn't a well-oiled play there. So it'll be second down and 10. Defensively for Talladega, we've got Chris Burney, Cameron Whiteley, we've got McKenzie, White, Montgomery, Calhoun, Wilson, McGregor, Scales, Bradley, and Ellis on that defensive side. second down and 10. You have to get to about the 2 for a first down. And timeout is called. Maybe an equipment problem here or something. Murphy's going to have to get Gooden out of the game. They bring in Carter at left tackle. Equipment issue, so he has to go out of the gate. Here's Tubb leaving it with the running back inside the 5, inside the 4-yard line before he's taken down. Penalty flags are down. A nice run by Parker, but 3 or 4 penalty flags are down. Let's check this one. You see, circling off left side and getting inside the 5-yard line, and penalty flags fly. The referee about to make the call here. Mumford has taken, after they recovered the fumble, have driven from the Talladega 40-yard line. And where the play stands, what the penalty is going to be, Talladega says, is against Mumford. He's spotted at about the 7-yard line. It's going to be a major distance penalty. Wow. That's a backbreaker. Personal foul.
Mumford
offense. That is not a good thing. So instead of inside the 5-yard line, you got a second down and very long. I'm about the 22. Smith on the carry again. He's knocked down behind the line of scrimmage at the 30. Good job defensively by John Ellis. One of the defensive backs coming up to make the tackle.
9 yards.
So Mumford looked like that they were going to have it inside the 5. A personal foul penalty is called against them, and they've got to get all the way. Inside the 15-yard line for the first down. They got it 3rd down and very long now. Caleb Cotton checks in for Mumford. Trips receivers to the left side for the bottom of the screen. Here is Tuck loading the throw. Fires in the end zone and is caught for the touchdown. Great catch. And that is Parker with the touchdown. And Parker goes up and a good throw by Tuck. And he just splits the coverage and not being able to get over there. Jay Spradley. So it's a touchdown for the Mumford Lions. They overcame the personal foul penalty. And 30-yard touchdown throw from Tuck to Parker. So Mumford on the board. Line of score 6-0 with a point after the foul. Mumford looks like they're going to go for 2 points here. Tuck will have Sistrunk sitting up beside him. Sistrunk is what they call that play. Dead with a headgear coming off of nine. Yeah, he got into the end zone. You have to wait and see. It's no good. So it's 6-0. Mumford with a 30-yard touchdown throw from Jay Tuck to Tadarius Parker. And Mumford leads it by a score of 6-0 with 6:21 to go in the first quarter. 30-second timeout. You're watching the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
Mumford recovers a fumble on the opening kickoff at the Talladega 40-yard line. And a 30-yard touchdown throw from Tuck to Parker puts Mumford on top, 6-0. Andrews prepares to kick off. And he drills it out of bounds. And Talladega should have it at the 35-yard line after the penalty. So Talladega already with the first turnover, the fumble, recovered by Mumford. And Mumford marches down the field. And 30-yard touchdown throw. The Lions are up 6-0. So we'll see now scales, who a lot of people are very, very high on for this Talladega football team. And you can be sure Mumford is going to keep an eye on number three. Scales is a good football player. He's loaded up to throw, puts it out in the flat, and it's caught, and not much room to go, you know. Here's Jay Spradley, and Mumford's defense is all over that. Toyer on the tackle. Good job defensively is Caleb Cotton, who works off the block and is first to get there. Second down. No gain on the play. Mumford leads 6-0. Scales rolling to throw. He's being pressured from behind. Hit as he throws. And it is tipped away at the last moment. That is Johnson on the coverage. Trying to get it to John Ellis. But pressure from the backside. And Scales, as hit as he throws, couldn't get as much on as he wanted to. And Ellis couldn't pull it in. Good coverage by the Mumford Lions. We got a heat timeout here with 5:31 to go in the first quarter. You're watching the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week on TV 24 and TV 47.
UOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships, live from Jordan-Hare.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know, moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
After the heat timeout, Talladega will have it third down and 10. Two incomplete passes, or one complete and for no gain, and this one is flipped out into the flat and making a little bit of headway is DeCorian Wilson, but he'll be well short of the first down. It'll be fourth down, and Talladega will punt it away. So Mumford, a salty defense here early in the football game. They lead it 6-0, under 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Just remember that Mumford recovered the opening kickoff, the fumble, and took it from there. And 30-yard touchdown throw and catch from Tuck to Parker puts the Lions up 6-0. Got a timeout here as Talladega calls a timeout with 4:41 to go in the first quarter. We're back right after this timeout.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy, and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street, or call 256-249-0322.
After the timeout by Talladega, well, if Talladega didn't have enough players on the field, they didn't have them in the right position or whatever, but they called a timeout. And they will now punt, with Munford leading this one by a score of 6-0. This is the first game for Talladega this year. And Munford 0-1 after being beaten handily by Oxford last week, 48-6. We got fourth down, and Talladega will punt it away. Munford, he got seven men up in the box and not putting much pressure on. And it's going to take a nice Talladega roll inside the 20-yard line and stop at about the 16. So Munford will take over there, leading by a score of 6-0. Appreciate all our sponsors being along with us tonight. Mama City Pharmacy, Sylacauga Glass, Cindy Pennington. Cindy Pennington presents the first downs, and we appreciate her being a partner with us this year. So Munford will get the football. And they lead it by a score of 6-0. With 4:03 to go in the first quarter. Beautiful, beautiful night for football. You know, temperatures this morning, like 55 degrees or so. And it's gonna be not quite that cool by daybreak in the morning, but it'll be cool. So it's a good thing as you get set for your Labor Day weekend. Tuck takes a snap. This time, Sistrunk has stood up at the line of scrimmage. Circling over to make the contact is Larry Calhoun, one of the linebackers. Second down now from the 14-yard line. .335 in the first quarter. Lost of a couple, second down and 12. Right back to Sistrunk again, and he might have gotten a yard too, might have gotten back to the original line of scrimmage. That'll bring him third down and long. CJ White helping out on the stop there. One time we'll take a third down and long. Munford leads it 6-0. And penalty flags down. They're backing Munford up. Legal procedure. Alliance. So third and very long now. But we've got to be careful here. They lead it. And they want to turn the football over down here. Third and long. Throwing on the run. And it's intercepted. Talladega with the interception. And the Tigers are going to take over deep in Munford territory. And you see running as Tuck and, Jay Tuck on the run, but he threw behind the intended receiver. And a good job defensively by John Ellis to make the interception for Talladega. So the Tigers will have it deep in Munford territory. So let's see if Talladega can do like Munford earlier and convert after the turnover. at the 14-yard line, first down and 10 for Talladega. Scales. And Munford don't give much room to Corian Wilson on the carry. And Peyton Gaither on the tackle for Munford. Lost about a yard, maybe 2 yards, so second down and 12 now. Munford defense, very, very active, very quick. So second down and 12. And timeout is called. Now they're ready to go. This is what Scales does. He throws on the run, and it is a touchdown for the Talladega Tigers. With the touchdown for Talladega, that is Scales does a lot of good stuff for Talladega, and he always making something happen. Make something happen there. It's 6-6 with a point after to follow. Montgomery with a point after. Kick it up. And the kick is good. So with a minute 29 left to go in the first quarter, Talladega with an interception and turning it into a touchdown, they lead Munford by a score of 7-6. More from me right after this.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Ox Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good. Things feeling a little uneven at home? Ox Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
So Talladega returns the favor as Talladega fumbled on the opening kickoff. Munford recovered and parlayed points out of it, and Talladega with an interception deep in Munford territory, and the Tigers get points. So 7-6 Talladega. Kickoff taken in at the 15-yard line across the 20, 25, 30. And finally, Russell down, hard running. That's Corbin Smith from Munford. Making the tackle is Christopher Burney for the Talladega Tigers. So it'll be a first down for Munford now at the 34-yard line. Munford brought a great crowd with them. You can see them afar, along the far side. It'll be first down and 10 with a minute 19 to go in the first quarter. Tuck turns and leaves it inside. Not a whole lot of running room. Smith on the carry. And out on the tackle is McGregor. Talladega. Got a yard, second down and 9. Blitz is coming. And trying to get outside and not able to do so. I think it's going to be a holding against Munford. Looked like Caleb Cotton reached and grabbed the jersey of Radarius Montgomery. It's probably going to be a holding against Munford. If that's the case, that'll mark it 10 yards. maybe Talladega declined the penalty. It's third down and very long, third and about 14. Tuck sends receivers all over the field. Lines up Smith on the slot now. And being thrown down. And a loss on the play. Getting in to make the play is McGregor. McGregor came untouched and just pulls the quarterback down. So a sack by McGregor. And they bring up fourth down. So Munford will punt and get a feeling how they're starting to feel themselves a little bit and beginning to settle in here at Mary Dooley Stadium, being their first game of the season. Andrew Williams is a punter for Munford. We got a timeout as the first quarter comes to a close. Munford trailing Talladega by a score of 7-6. Back with more Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week after this.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
Back at Mary Dooley Stadium in Talladega as the Munford Lions and Talladega Tigers getting together for inter-county rivalry. Munford 0-1 on the season. Talladega with their first game of the year. And Coach Hennenfelder had, I think, just 2 days before media day and had to put this team together very late in the summer. And a nice kick, a punt return, and catching a little run is McGregor. McGregor runs inside the 35-yard line. McGregor just caught that thing on the fly and did a good job. Let's see where they mark it at about the 33-yard line. So Talladega will have it first and 10. Talladega with a 7-6 lead. 11:50 to go in the half. Scales. Quarterback. Scales turns and gives it to Wilson. Wilson's inside the 30 to about the 27. Simmons on the tackle. Dree Simmons. So second down at about 7. We might get a loss of a yardage, excuse me. It's at the 36-yard line. They've got the second down at 12 now. Off left tackle. They've got a whole lot of running room. They go back to Wilson and Simmons again on the tackle along with the Sistra. So it'll be third down and 11. Talladega trying to add points to their lead, lead at 7-6. Mentioned at the top, Talladega's basketball team won their first ever state championship. last year. They want to move that way in football as well. Fuscal's pulling it down 30, 25. He's inside the 25. Penalty flag is down. And there's some pushing and shoving going on. And Johnson was the perpetrator there. And he and Scales kind of pushed and shoved out of bounds. And then it continued after the play ended. And I don't know if they're going to have offsetting penalties. Or is it they just go against Munford, unless they personal foul against the Lions. So you'll add... you'll add the penalty onto that. It's really unnecessary. And right there in front of the official, and they're going to catch that every time. You know, a lot of these kids know each other. They're not far apart as far as communities are concerned. They're a little amped up a little bit. You see the little pushing and shoving going on. The officials are quick to get in there, and coaches help out and make sure everybody gets where they need to be. That's McGregor on the carry for Talladega that time. McGregor, a big guy. Picked up a yard or two. Talladega leading by a score of 7-6 at the Munford 10-yard line. .9:35 to go in the first half. Scales has Wilson back there with him. Scales pumps to throw, throws, and it is short of the intended receiver. So that'll stop the clock. With the incomplete pass. Trying to get it to Jay Spradlin. It's incomplete. So third down. We don't have the football back spotted as of yet. Now they will get it. Third down and goal from the 10. Now official stop play. Referee talking to Shannon Felder. Now then they'll reset things. And try it again. Third down and goal for Talladega at the Munford 10-yard line. Not quite as smooth as you'd like to see it. First game jitters a little bit. Scales looking to throw it. He's got some running room on the right side. And he now throws and is intercepted in the end zone. Sistrunk with the interception. Sistrunk down the sideline. And the big guy rambles all the way over the 45-yard line to the 47. Wow. Big interception in the end zone by Justin Sistrunk. And you see, Tuck had some running room, but he throws it into traffic. And Sistrunk, 3 yards deep in the end zone, brings it out. And he's all the way across the 47-yard line for a first down for Munford. So the second turnover of the night, interception and a fumble so far for the Talladega Tigers. Munford with an injured player. The officials are talking things over. It may have been a penalty flag there, not sure. Flag at about the 35-yard line. And looks like it's going to take him a little while to unravel this one. Sistrunk with the interception. and the big guy rumbles out of the end zone all the way up near midfield. But the penalty flag is back at the 35. And obviously, it happened after the interception. We'll see here what the officials decide with the penalty flag. Still nothing yet. Penalties against Munford. Unsportsmanlike conduct, so it's a penalty both ways. Let's see where they end up spotting it. It's all the way at the Munford, Talladega 49 yard line. Munford will have it in Talladega territory after the interception and the penalty. They're not quite set to go yet. Another flag down. They had too many players on the field. Yep. Munford had 13 players on the field. The only play with so many, and so Munford had one or two extra. Running room for Smith, and Smith got a chance to take this from a distance, and he's knocked down inside the five to about the 3 yard line. Just a little delay handoff to Smith. Smith showed great speed. You see him make the cut right there, make one of the Talladega defenders miss, and he's off to the races. And Scale saves a touchdown. Slows him down enough to get some help across the way. So it'll be first and goal for Munford at the Talladega 2 yard line. Munford trails 7-6. And for the first and goal. And this time Smith is slammed down. Defensively, CJ White with the tackle. So second down and goal. 8:22 the clock running. Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week, brought to you in part by State Representative Ron Johnson, District 33. Second and goal. Again, Talladega with great penetration. This time is Larry Calhoun. So third and goal. Cindy Pennington with our first down coverage this year's games. So third down and goal now for Munford. And they're at the 7 yard line now. A couple of losses on the two previous plays, and they're late getting this play in. Munford's going to have to call a timeout. 7:10 to go in the first half. Talladega 7, Munford 6, back after this.
WOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships, live from Jordan-Hare.
So, Munford having to call a timeout because they weren't quite set on the play they were wanting to run. So it's third down and goal. Talladega love to make a stand right here after a long run by Smith of Munford. Put it inside the 5-yard line, but Talladega with a couple of defensive plays and pushed it back to the 7, now a third and goal. Three turnovers in the football game. The first two have led to points, one by one touchdown by either team. And now Munford, after an interception by Sistrunk, has it third and goal at the Talladega 7. Talladega jumped offside, looks like. Like the right defensive end there jumped, or tackle. So half the distance to the goal. Looks like Chris Burney may have jumped a little bit. So it'll be third and goal for the Munford Lions. 7-6, Talladega with the lead. 7-10 to go in the first half. Tuck throws it. Got a man wide open with a touchdown. Wow. How he got that wide open, I don't know. But that's Grady Russell with the touchdown catch. And he just floats it out there with a touchdown. And I don't know, Russell got behind the coverage. And it's 12-7 now. Munford with the lead. Probably go for two right here. They're leading 12-7. Grady Russell's a junior. He'll line up to this side with a two-point conversion to follow. Got Sistrunk lined up to take the snap, and penalty flags fly again. See a lot of these in the first game or two of the year, penalties. Just little things that derail the train a little bit. Legal procedure against Munford. So we'll try the two-point conversion again. Sistrunk lines up. Now then they'll throw the two-point conversion. This is Flint. Throwing the two-point conversion, and that was to Parker, and it counts as a two-point conversion. And John Ellis said, "Hey, that's on me." So it was 14-7, Munford with the lead over Talladega after the two-point conversion attempt. Remember, three turnovers has led to three scores, two by Munford and one by Talladega. So with 7:06 to go in the first half, Munford with a 14-7 lead. Talladega looked like they were going in, and Scales throws an interception. The Sistrunk returns out near midfield, then a penalty gave Munford the ball inside Talladega's 50-yard line. And so they convert that one. After a big run by Corbin Smith, got it inside the 5. So it's 14-7 now. Munford with the lead. Williams to kick it away. And a long line drive is caught by one of the up men for Talladega. That's Jadis Lee. And Lee gets up to the 40-yard line. So first down for Talladega. Trailing 14-7 with 6:59 to go in the half. Good field position, good starting position for Talladega here. You don't see it often when you have three turnovers and they all lead to points. But that's what's happened here in the first half. Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega, Alabama. Talladega with the football at their 39-yard line. Scales rolling to throw, throws on the run, caught. And cutting back inside and all the way to the 48-yard line is Michael McGregor. McGregor with a good run after the catch. And it'll be a first down. So Cindy Pennington, first down. Hard running by DeCorgan Wilson. You know, Wilson played basketball too, and he keeps bullying his way for extra yardage. DeCorgan Wilson. Talladega on the Munford side of the 50-yard line now. With 6 minutes before the half at the 45-yard line. This may be the final play before the heat timeout here. Quarterback keeper and boy, being met in a hurry. That is Simmons on the tackle, and he slams the quarterback scales down. There's a flag down. Talladega says that's against Munford. And it is. Inverted face mask. So it'll be second down now. And the heat timeout is going to be taken right here. The Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. We're in Talladega, Alabama, Mary Dumas Stadium. Munford leads Talladega 14-7. Heat timeout with Munford leading Talladega 14-7. Good bit of offense by both these teams. And penalties have played a role in it as well as turnovers. Remember as we started tonight, Talladega fumbled the opening kickoff. Munford recovered and got points out of that. Talladega got points out of a turnover from Munford, and then Munford scored again off of Talladega interception. And so that's where we stand now, 14-7. Talladega got something working here at the 43-yard line after the heat timeout in Munford territory. Second down and short. Scales, the quarterback. Talladega's got some veterans back from last year's team. Scales slips a handoff to Wilson. Wilson is close to the first down. Actually, he turned it and slipped down, so he lost a yard or two. So bring up third down and about three now. Scales lost his footing as he tried to cut. And Wilson lost his footing as he tried to cut, so it'll be third down and short at the 44-yard line. We haven't seen Scales run as much as we thought he might. He's looking to throw. Throwing on the run, caught, nice safe pass inside the 40-yard line. Reception to Isaiah Cunningham. So it'll be a Sydney Pennington first down at the 39. Talladega trying to put a drive here together. Trailing 14-7. Scales to Wilson. And Wilson is hit and driven back. Smith on the tackle along with Sistrunk. Approaching 4 minutes now in the half. Second down and seven. Both bands performing at halftime. Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week on TV 47 and TV 24. Scales throws, got a man wide open and caught inside the 30 and bullying his way inside the 25-yard line. Michael McGregor on the reception. It's a Sydney Pennington first down. You see the replay there. And he fights off that tackle and pushes inside the 25-yard line. So it'll be first down and 10 for Talladega with 3:20 to go in the half. Another Sydney Pennington first down. Replay is brought to you by the Greater Coosa Valley Area Chamber of Commerce, Tom Roberts and the staff there. Scales loading up, looking, throwing in the end zone, too tall for the intended receiver as it was inside the 10-yard line, trying to get to Ellis, but it was overthrown. Second down and 10. At Mary Dugan Stadium in Talladega, Alabama. A home opener for the Talladega Tigers. Both these teams are with new coaches this year. Coach Easley and Coach Felder for their respective teams of Munford and Talladega. This time, receiver splits the seam inside the 20-yard line to about the 15. That is Spratling on the reception. He's wide open at the 15-yard line before he's taken down. Parker with a tackle. And a timeout is called here with 2:50 to go, with Munford leading Talladega by a score 14-7. Back with more after this.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know, moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
So after the timeout, Talladega will continue the drive at the Munford 15-yard line. O'Shannon Velmer plays collegiate football at Alabama. Came in very late for Talladega as Ted Darby was let go and Shannon Velmer was hired. It was thought that Darby was going to take the job at White Plains, and Board of Education voted that down, Calhoun County. So he was let go at Talladega, and Shannon Velmer steps in. Scales to Wilson. Wilson is inside the 15 to about the 13-yard line. Defensively is Thunderbird on the tackle. Make that Jonathan Miller. So Miller off right tackle, a little shaken up there for Talladega on that right side. He stays in there. Second down and 9. Penalty flag down as the catch is made inside the 5 to the 3. That's Michael McGregor. Let's check the penalty. May have been holding on the one of the defensive backs. They picked the flag up, and it's going to go against Talladega. Wow. That's a major distance penalty, too, 15 yards. Legal block. Boy, you didn't need that. That's a major distance penalty. He's thrown in the interior line, so. So you wipe off the big play, and the ball is marked now at the 29-yard line. Don't see that a whole lot, but occasionally. You call it a chop block or a block below the knees, and they're trying to protect the player's knees and ankles. Scales on the run, flips it, it's incomplete. Scales just running for his life then. Minute 33 to go. You see him being flushed out of the pocket and just flips it out here. And, Wilson really wasn't looking for it, and he got hammered at the 29-yard line. Third down now. Ball spotted at the 31. And Talladega's going to have to call a timeout. Because Felder not liking what he sees here. 14-7, Munford with a minute 33 to go. And we'll be back with more from Mary Dumas Stadium right after this.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy, and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street, or call 256-249-0322.
14-7, Munford leads Talladega, minute 33 to go in the half. And Talladega calls a timeout. Make sure they get the right play call and the right set that they want, the right players on the field that they want. 93 seconds left to go in the half. And Scales brings his club out. He's got Wilson in the backfield with him. looking to throw. He's flushed out of the pocket, throws on the run. It's incomplete. And about the 10-yard line, he's trying to get it to McGregor, but it was short, and it'll bring up a fourth down for Talladega. So Talladega will go for it here with a minute 28 to go in the half. Munford Lions, Class 5A, Talladega Class 4A. So fourth down, Talladega's got to get to about the 15-yard line. And whistles blow again. We had a lot of that tonight in the first half. Wait the official's call. Delay a game. Wow. Sure didn't want that. After an incomplete pass, you get a delay a game penalty. See what they're going to do here. Looks like they're going to punt now. Munford's not sure what Talladega's going to do, so they got everybody up. And going to mark off penalty against Talladega. Delay a game. They may have wanted that one. I don't know, to give them a little more room to punt, but that's back-to-back delay a game penalties. I don't see that often at all. So Talladega will punt it away. And Onique Deer. His punt rolls into the end zone. So Munford will have it. First and 10 with a minute 18 to go in the first half. Munford leads it 14-7. And don't forget, coming up at halftime, the bands for both teams will be performing. We'll have some highlights coming out of the break. And so I invite you to stay with us for the second half of Munford and Talladega, 14-7. With Munford with the football at their own 20-yard line. First down and 10 for Jay Tuck running the show. Tuck leaves it inside. This young man has ran the ball well in the first half. His name is Corbin Smith, sophomore.
Corbin Smith on the carry.
Looks like they're just going to let that clock run to get to halftime. 14-7, Munford with the lead, second down. And Smith picked up about 4 yards, so second down and 6. Smith again with it. He's got some running room. And he bounces off one tackler. He's got the first down, and he'll go out of bounds near the 40-yard line. Smith with showing nice ability. It's the first down for Munford. Now they were 42 seconds to go. That's a Sidney Pennington first down. Let's see if Munford tries to get down the field. Flag down again. My goodness. I guess they waved that one off. No, they didn't either. Legal substitution against Munford. That may have been from either a player late getting in or too many players on the field. dancing out of bounds, assist drop. About the 37-yard line. Not much happening there. Second down now. And 12. Jay Tuck, the junior quarterback. Gives to Smith off left end. Smith dances down the sideline, goes out of bounds. Couple more flags down. Officials getting a workout tonight. Let's see what they call here. Ball's at the 45-yard line. It's going to go against Talladega. That's not going to help the Tigers. It's a major distance penalty, too. Personal foul. Wow. Coach Feller's not going to like that. So it was a first down for Munford, and Munford getting in range where they can get some points here, possibly, at the 40-yard line. Here's Tuck with a quick pass, incomplete. Off the hands of Sistrunk. So second down and 10. 27.4 seconds remaining in the half. Munford leads it 14-7. We've been back and forth here in the second quarter, but it's been really hampered by penalties. Tuck looking, throws, caught on the sideline, out of bounds. Time to stop the clock at the 35-yard line. Reception made by Parker. So it's third down and 5. Munford would love to get more points here before halftime. Talladega really needs to make a stop. They've hurt themselves badly with major distance penalties. Tuck again looking, and it's picked off, almost picked off. Wow. McGregor had nothing but green grass. The pass was tipped, and McGregor had it and couldn't hold it. He could have scored on that play. He knows it too. He had that thing and just got away from it. I think McKenzie's one's got his hands up and tipped that pass. So we got another timeout here now with a little bit of time left in the half. We'll take a timeout and back with more from Mary Dumas Stadium after this.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Ox Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good.
Things feeling a little uneven at home?
Ox Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
So after a timeout, Coach Michael easily took that one for Munford. Fourth down and 5 from the 35-yard line. Munford wants to make sure they get a right call made here. Corbin Smith has been the big play guy for Munford so far in the half. And he's got it off left end. He skirts left end. He looks like he's got the first down. They are going to move the chains. When they needed some yardage, they go to Corbin Smith, the sophomore running back, number 32. First down and 10 now. Only 15.2 seconds left. Munford's at the 29-yard line. Smith's got it again right up the middle of the field. Running room. And he's inside the 15-yard line, dials out of bounds. As a heads-up play, getting out of bounds is Corbin Smith. He's running laterally and gets out of bounds at about the 18. He had a big, big hole. And does a heady thing and dives out of bounds to stop the clock. So Munford may have two more plays, maybe. They're at the 18-yard line. Tough jump ball in the end zone and is caught. And see the official going to mark it. Yeah, they're going to give it to him at the 2. And that is Parker again. Parker with that jump ball situation. And he just out jumps the defender. One-on-one coverage. And Tuck put it where nobody could catch it. But Parker, and it'll be first and goal. That's a Cindy Pennington first down. So they got one play to go here at the 2-yard line. And this will be a big stop for Talladega. If they can make it, it'd be a big touchdown for Munford if they can get it in. Penalty flags are down. We've had those tonight in the first half, haven't we? Let's see, we'll try to figure this out. And it's against Talladega. Offside, oh my goodness. Mark it at the 1-yard line now. So Munford will try from the 1. Officials are talking things over among themselves. And first game for everybody. Except for Munford, this is their second game. Keeping himself and dancing in the end zone as the first half comes to a close. That is Jay Tuck. And Tuck with a touchdown and just a great play call. Everybody thought that Sistrunk was going to get it, but Tuck takes it in himself and it is 20-7. And Tuck's injured on the play. That's a big touchdown right there. Very late in the half. It didn't look like Munford was going to try anything. Then a couple of penalties against Talladega, a couple of big runs by Corbin Smith. And all of a sudden, Munford scored again. They're going to try for the 2-point conversion here. And slipping into the end zone with a 2-point conversion of Sistrunk. And it is 22-7. Wow, who would have thought that? Well, the officials get their notepads out again. But the first half has come to a close as Munford leads the Talladega Tigers with a late touchdown in the first half, 22-7. This is the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. Both bands will be performing shortly. We'll be back after this.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
WOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships, live from Jordan-Hare.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know, moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy, and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street, or call 256-249-0322.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Ox Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good. Things feeling a little uneven at home? Ox Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
WOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships live from Jordan-Hare.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know, moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy, and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street, or call 256-249-0322.
Back at Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega, Alabama. Mumford Lions lead Talladega 21, make it 22-7 at halftime. And first half highlights, and there were a lot of them. We had a lot of turnovers in the first half. And our new physical therapy high school game of the week. And you see here, as a nice touchdown throw and catch, that is from Jay Tuck to Parker. Parker connected on a couple of those. And here's Talladega back the other way, throwing in the end zone, had a guy open, and is intercepted by Tuck. And Tuck, the big linebacker, he rambles all the way across near midfield, and the penalty flag puts the ball at the 48-yard line. And Munford in business again. And they get the two-point conversion, and they lead it by a score of 22-7 at halftime. And three turnovers in the first half. The opening kickoff, Munford recovered a fumble by Talladega special teams, turned that into points. Talladega off a turnover scored points, and then Munford again off of a turnover scored more points. And so it's 22-7, Munford with the lead. And that late touchdown in the first half was really, really tough for Talladega. As Munford, it looked like that they were just going to run the clock out. Got a couple of first down runs by Corbin Smith, a couple of penalties against Talladega. And next thing you know, Munford is knocking on the door again. And they score a touchdown on the last play of the half. And the two-point conversion to follow, and that's where we stand now at 22-7. Jay Tuck played well in the first half for Munford. The guy that really stood out is Corbin Smith, the young running back who's just a sophomore. Tardarius Parker with a couple of key touchdown catches for Talladega. You don't have to look very far to see that Talladega has got some athletes. Scales is one of those, Wilson is another, McGregor is another. But Talladega's gonna have to put something together here in the second half as they trail Munford 22-7. As we get set to go in the third quarter, Michael Easley, the head football coach at Munford, I'm sure he told his team at halftime, that's just exactly what we wanted. A touchdown at the end of the half. And Talladega, on the other hand, they hurt themselves a lot in the first half with penalties and turnovers. And Munford leads us with a score of 22-7. We'll get a quick break in and come back with the second half kickoff. Munford and Talladega, second half, Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega, right after this.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Ox Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good. Things feeling a little uneven at home? Ox Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Munford beaten handily by Oxford last week. Oxford, a powerhouse football team, and the Talladega and Calhoun County lines are, you know, right there close together. And Munford kind of almost straddles Calhoun County. And so Munford and Oxford play last week, and Munford moves a little bit south to take on Talladega tonight. And doing a pretty good job. They lead it by a score of 22-7 as Talladega will kick off to begin the second half. Munford leads it 22-7. Talladega set to kick it away. Donahue Physical Therapy, High School Game of the Week. And we're underway here in the second half. At the 5-yard line across the 20-25, and this is Smith again. Look at this guy go. He's an excellent player. And he's knocked down along the Talladega sideline. But Smith, as we mentioned in the first half, Corbin Smith, he's a sophomore. And he's got good speed, and he's got deceptive moves. So that's a combination for Munford. And the Lions will have it at the 43-yard line. Leading 22-7. Jay Tuck, again at quarterback. He was injured in the first half, and he's back. Handoff inside for a couple of 3 yards of Smith again on the carry. Talladega's got an injured player. And C.J. White, he's a mainstay with this Talladega defense, and he feels like this is a serious injury because he's getting people out there very quickly. Maybe just a cramp. Hopefully it's just a cramp. We'll take a look at it when we come back. 22-7, Munford over Talladega.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
And injured player hepped off the field. That's White, and he seems to be in pretty good shape. Again, Smith on the carry for Munford. He's a hard-working running back at the 47-yard line. Third down at about 5. Munford leads it 22-7. They'd love to put this drive in the end zone after finishing the first half with a strong drive. And throwing, and the catch is caught. The receiver, Parker, we saw him catch 4 or 5 balls in the first half. He catches that one for a first down for Munford up at the Talladega 43-yard line. So first down for the Lions. Drive continues. Cindy Pennington first down. Sistrunk off right in. Sistrunk breaks a couple of tackles inside the 40-yard line. Penalty flag is down. We saw a ton of that in the first half. We're less than 2 minutes in the third quarter, and we've got another one here. And that's the second time tonight we've seen that chop block call. Blocking below the knees, and that's going to cost Munford 15 yards. Penalty flag thrown in rather late. That's a 15-yarder. So that changed things significantly as the ball is moved back to the 48-yard line. First down and 15 now. Johnson. Johnson's still moving. Johnson's got the first down. Didn't take long for that. You see Johnson off left end, and he cuts it inside and got some running room, and another flag is down. And he would have had the first down, but this one may come back too. Munford walking backwards. That's usually a sign it's not good news. So yet another penalty against the Lions. It's a 10-yard mark off. So they've had 25 yards marked off in penalties the last two plays. So spotted at the 38-yard line. First down and very long, first and 28. Tuck gives to Smith. Smith circling right in. Slips a one tackler, but pulled down at the 43-yard line. Over to make the stop defensively. For Talladega's Larry Calhoun. And Talladega's got a man on the field hurt, and another penalty flag is down as well. We'll sort all this out, and we'll come back to Mayor Dumas Stadium in just a minute. Munford leading Talladega by a score of 22-7.
UOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships live from Jordan-Hare.
And we're so proud to be a part of the family of networks as has the Alabama High School Athletic Association regular season, playoffs, and all sports for the next couple of years. WOTM, TV 47, Alabama Cable Network, legal procedure against Munford, that's declined. So they had double penalties. So that is two penalties of blocking below the knees against Munford in this drive alone. And so it's going to be first down and looks like 45 yards to go. Talladega's injured player being tended to with a big interior lineman with a right knee injury, apparently. And that's a young man who was hurt a little bit earlier but this time it seemed a little bit more serious. That's C.J. White being attended to and helped across the sideline. I don't know how many plays you got for first down and 45 yards to go, but it's all the way back near the 25-yard line now. Jay Tuck will take the snap and gives to Smith. Smith fumbles the football and falls back on it. And Smith was very fortunate to get that one back. He just dropped the football. It wasn't contact, he just saw it pop out of his hand. At the 26-yard line. Smith again. Official had to get out of the way on that with Smith right up the middle. Got a nice gain, but he's got a long way to go for the first down. 8:30 to go in the third quarter, Munford 22. And Talladega 7. Sattenfelder has seen his team take a 7-6 lead, and then Munford with 2 second quarter touchdowns, one as the first half ended. Go right back to Smith. Smith trying to break a tackle. Can't get out of the grasp of one of the Tiger defenders, Larry Calhoun. So third down and fourth down now and a short 31 yards to go. I would say that Munford probably punt, wouldn't you? There's been 3 chop blocks, penalties, major distance penalties called in this game. I know 2 of those went against Munford in this drive. Line drive punt that takes a Talladega roll and we touch that at the 34-yard line. Out on the coverage is Peyton Gaither. So Talladega will have it first and 10. Trailing 22-7 with 7:03 to go in the third quarter. Don't forget Pigskin Roundup after the game, about 10:30 tonight. If you can't stay up, you can DVR it and watch it tomorrow. But if you can stay up, stay with us. Friends at TV24 do a great job of that. Scales throws behind the intended receiver. Incomplete. Trying to get it to John Ellis. We threw behind John, so second down. .658 to go in the third quarter. Talladega made the playoffs last year, lost to Headland in the first round, 14-6. And actually led in that game 6-0. Scales throwing and almost intercepted by Sistrunk. Sistrunk's been all over the field tonight for Munford. He had that thing in his hands and it just couldn't pull it in. So incompletion stops the clock. Third down and 10. Munford leading 22-7. Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. We're at Mary Dewey Stadium in Talladega, Alabama. Here's Scales, and he's got a man wide open in and out of the hands of the intended receiver who's running free, Michael McGregor. McGregor just saw it slip through his fingertips, and I bring up fourth down, a penalty flag is out. And we'll see what the call is here. Legal procedure against Talladega. So they'll mark off 5 yards and third down again. At the 29-yard line, third down and 15. Scales being pressured and now dumps it off incomplete. And he was just trying to get rid of that one. Big, big pressure by Simmons of Munford. And that'll bring up fourth down. Munford with a 22-7 lead. And you can tell that they played a game last week in Talladega, didn't. And you can tell that Coach Schoenfelder is just getting his team kind of trying to get them where he wants them to be. And I'm sure they'll get there. But they got a long hill to climb tonight. And whistles blow again. Let's see what they're going to call here. Delay a game against Talladega. It's those little things again that on time first game, and a bad snap. And Talladega's not going to get the playoff. And it hit the snapper back, hit one of the up men with a snap. And Munford swarms all over it. And the Tigers, the Lions will have the football deep in Talladega territory at the 21-yard line. Another mistake. And that one just... the snap didn't get to where it needed to go. So Munford deep in Talladega territory with a chance to expand their lead. Jay Tuck, the quarterback, and Tuck gives it to Johnson. Johnson fumbles the football, and he's taken down around the 13-yard line. Johnson got a nice block right there. Then as he tries to get away, he coughs the football up. Unfortunately, a teammate got on it. So a second down and two. 6:05 to go. We might get this playoff before the heat timeout. Let's see. Folks looking at one another. We're going to get it off. Now then they stop playing. And Munford calls a timeout. 5:48 to go. We're going to get a timeout in. Munford 22, Talladega 7.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know, moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy, and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street, or call 256-249-0322.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Ox Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good. Things feeling a little uneven at home? Ox Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
Well, we had the heat timeout as well while we're away, so after that we're set to go second down and two for Munford. Running room inside the five, diving to the end zone, touchdown, Johnson. Johnson from 12 yards out, and Munford increases their lead, and Johnson just hit a hole, and there's nobody there for Talladega. And it's 28-7. From Munford expands their lead, and they will apparently go for two here. Tuck will take the snap. Low snap, and the two-point conversion is going to fail. So with 5:41 to go in the third quarter, Munford 28 and Talladega 7. Back to Mary Dumas Stadium after this.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
So Munford with a turnover, and they lead it by a score of 28-7 after the touchdown. And Talladega hurt themselves on that punt, or attempted punt, with a snap. Hit one of the up men, and Munford took over on downs and didn't take them long to get in the end zone. On the kickoff. One of the up men for Talladega picks it up, and that's Jadis Lee. And he's taken down, and Munford, Talladega will go to work at their 35-yard line, trailing by a score of 28-7 with 5:34 to go in the third quarter. We've had a lot of turnovers, and a lot of turnovers has resulted in points. Most of them by Munford. So Talladega will have it first and 10, trailing by three scores. And the Munford Lions, they are just feeling it now. As roaring through to make the tackle is Cedric Lawson. And Lawson just beat the blocker and slammed the ball carrier down. So a second down and long now. Lee on the carry. Loss of about four, second down and 14. Munford defense is fired up. Oh, Scales, who's been relatively quiet tonight. Some running room up the middle. That's Lee again on carry. Third down and 10. 4:25 to go in the third quarter. Munford 28, Talladega 7. Munford with a three-man rush. And floating it out in the backfield. Incomplete. Got to bring up fourth down. For the Tigers. And they will punt it away again. Last time they didn't have any success in punting it as it never got back to the punter, Deer. Monique Deer, the punter. But he hit one of the up men. It resulted in Munford taking over on downs. Tom Ligger late getting a player in. Lee hurrying into the game to be that 11th player. And a low line drive kick almost hit one of the linemen, but it takes a great Talladega bounce and is stopped at the 28-yard line. That thing didn't get 3 or 4 feet high on the punt itself. So Munford will take over at their 28-yard line, leading 28-7. Let's see how Talladega's defense responds here with their backs against the wall. They've got to get the football back, trailing by three scores. And Munford has had their way with Talladega, especially in the second quarter and so far here in the third. Lance Smith hurries out of the game for Munford. Johnson, the ball carrier, and Johnson still running. A penalty flag is down, however. At about the 30-yard line, Johnson's tackled at the 35. We appreciate all our sponsors, Donahue Physical Therapy, State Representative Ron Johnson, Marble City Pharmacy, Curtis and Son Funeral Home, Silicaga Glass, Sydney Pennington, Greater Coosa Valley Area Chamber of Commerce, Stop and Shop Auto Sales, Lori Darling, and you know, if you want some good eating for Labor Day weekend, it's Lori Darling in Fayetteville, Alabama. And I'm telling you, if you want barbecue for your Labor Day weekend, you just don't want to cook and you want some good cooking for barbecue, it's Lori Darling's in Fayetteville, Alabama. Can't go wrong there for sure. Penalty against Munford. And the ball was marked holding against the Lions. There's two penalties on Munford. They declined one, Talladega did, and took the other one. So it's inside the 20-yard line for Munford now. First down and 25. Clock running at 3:35, low snap, and it's going in the end zone. That's going to be a safety. So low snap, and that's another miscue, this time by Munford. And you see this right here, and it just never got off the ground. And Talladega gets on the ball carrier as Michael McGregor made sure that ball carrier stayed in the end zone. So it's 28-9. Munford will have to punt it away, and Talladega will get it back. Some weird things happening tonight at Mary Dumas Stadium for sure. Don't see many safeties in high school football. But there was one right there. That gives 2 points to Talladega. And the Tigers will get the football back. And look, just when Talladega was beginning to stumble a little bit, they got new life. And should get excellent field position. Munford elects to kick instead of punt. They can do either. Andrew Williams will kick it away. You're set to go. I think. And it's going to be kicked down the middle of the field, taken at the 38-yard line. And that's McGregor. McGregor's across the 45. So Talladega with good field position. Touchdown, get him right back in the game. They mark it at the 47-yard line. McGregor's going to have to come out of the game. Looks like he's got a cramp. And you see this too. You know, you're getting late in the football game, third quarter, almost over. And you see those guys starting to cramp up. It's a hot, humid night. Scales to throw. Not a real deep route, and a pickup of only a yard. Isaiah Cunningham. With the reception. And, he got about a yard, and that's it. From the 47-yard line. Under 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Munford 28, Talladega 9. Next week, Talladega will play Appalachian. It's up in Aniana. Blitz is coming, stepping up and throwing, and it's intercepted. Poor choice. And with the interception down the sideline and knocked out of bounds is Johnson. Poor choice by quarterback Scales as he was hit and tried to throw it, and as he was going down, and nice reaction by Johnson, and Johnson has it inside the 25-yard line. Munford will first down and 10, another turnover, this time an interception. Scales trying to make something happen, and his athletic ability did not help him then. At the 22-yard line, first and 10. Tuck a little late getting out there, but now he's set to go at quarterback. Smith, Sylvester Smith, the ball carry.
Sylvester Smith on the carry.
Second down now. Pick up about five. Munford making sure they run all that clock down if they can. Off right in. Not a whole lot of running room for Smith then. Penalty flag is down. And that's against Munford. Maybe another holding call. We've had a lot of those tonight. See 55 with a hole right there. So that'll push Munford back at the 27-yard line. Here's Smith. Smith cuts it back inside, still moving, and still running hard. He may have fumbled the football. Tom Lincoln says they've got the football, and the official not indicating anything. Now they're going to talk about it. Talladega pointing that they've had it. Munford says they got it. And it's Talladega football. As Munford fumbles, Smith trying to get that extra yardage. And he just has it ripped out of his hands. Right there. Good job by the Talladega defense. And that's Michael McGregor again. So McGregor with a good job creating the turnover and recovering the fumble. So the Tigers have it now. Man, back and forth we go. Ugh. Nothing happening inside there. That was hard hitting by the Munford defense. I put the bonnet on you, and that was 55 for Munford. I think that's Thunderbird, I believe. And they let the clock run down to end the third quarter, with Munford leading 28-9 over the Talladega Tigers. Mary Dumas Stadium in Talladega, Alabama. We'll be back with the fourth quarter right after this.
UOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships, live from Jordan-Hare.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know, moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy, and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street, or call 256-249-0322.
Back in Talladega, Alabama at Mary Dumas Stadium. Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week as we move to the fourth quarter now. Second down and 14 for the Tigers. And they're at their own 14-yard line. Trailing 28-9. Blitz is coming. Scales throws out of the backfield, incomplete. Off the hands of the intended receiver, that is Wilson, DeCorian Wilson. We got third down now. Talladega needs to get something going. Wilson is limping off the field. And they bring Cunningham in. So third down. And about 19. Jammed up at the line of scrimmage. There's a ball carrier for Talladega, and that's the lead. And we got fourth out. So with 11:30 to go in the football game, Munford 28, Talladega 9. Munford led early, Talladega took the lead, and Munford came back and have led since the first quarter. Talladega's had some snapper back problems this time. They get it, and it's a pretty good punt this time. Matter of fact, it's a great punt. Rolling inside the 40 and stopping at the 35-yard line. Making sure that he got a good leg into that one. He's a punter deer. He's a senior. Did a good job then. So Munford will take over. 10:51 to go in the game, leading 28-9. Michael Easley, some last minute instruction for his team as they head back on the field. There's Smith again. Smith picks up about 6 yards. Maybe a little more than that. Second down, and about 3. Munford has been able to move the ball on the ground against Talladega's defense. Tuck will take the snap and give off to Smith again. Smith bounces inside, now outside, and he is hammered. Great open field tackle by John Ellis. Ellis just got a running start. Smith trying to get outside, and Ellis just knocked him backwards. It's a first down for Munford. Cindy Pennington first down. Across midfield to the Tiger 49-yard line. Smith on the carry. Talladega with a good stop by McKenzie. Contavious McKenzie. Munford. The Lions with the ball, and they're starting to feel good about this one if they can just keep moving the chains. High snap. Off again with it is Smith. Smith's got 9 yards. Third down and very short. Eight and a half to go in the game. You're only going to get a couple more possessions if you're Talladega. You got to make a stop here. Third down and short. trying to get there for the first down. I don't know if he got it. I don't think so. Smith pulling his way forward, but it's going to be short. Talladega, a good job defensively. So fourth down at the 40-yard line. Coach easily gets a play in. Now they set their offense. Talladega's got nine up in the box. And I don't think he made it. Talladega stiffens defensively. A great job by the Talladega defense. That's Justin Barclay, who stuck his helmet in there and got that stop, and Talladega will take over on downs. Good job by the Tigers defense. So it gives the offense the football back with a first down and 10 from the 40-yard line. Talladega's got to make something happen, though. They trail by a couple of scores. There's Scales giving way to Wilson. Wilson is taken down. And he'll keep moving that clock right along the sidelines. Johnson on the stop for Munford. 7 minutes to go. Second down and 5. Munford trying to even up their record at 1-1. Talladega, their first game of the season. Off left end. This lead. And ball's on the ground, and Munford comes up with it. So Lee fumbles. And White recovers for Munford. He made a nice run. But then the ball is coughed up. And Munford gets on it. So it'll be a first down for the Lions. Between penalties and turnovers for Talladega. Apparently, his contact with the ground caused a fumble. But Munford's going to get it. Sandlin on the carry for Munford. Clock moves on at 6:15. Munford's not in any kind of hurry here. Jay Tuck has run the offense most of the way tonight for the Munford Lions. He'll bring his team up. Second down and 3. Off right in. First down and more. Still moving down the sideline. That turned out to be more than what it looked like it was going to be. Johnson turned that into a big run inside the 20-yard line now. It looked like that Talladega was going to string him out, but Johnson cut it back and just kept running. And we may have a heat timeout here with 5:34 to go in the football game. Munford 28 and Talladega 9.
Hot under the collar because your basement is full of water? Call a local company you can trust. Ox Foundation Solutions. We use the most advanced water management system to stop water from invading your basement for good.
Things feeling a little uneven at home?
Ox Foundation Solutions will fix your uneven concrete sidewalk, driveway, or basement in no time. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
5:34 to go in the football game. Munford 28, Talladega 9, and Munford with a first down and 10 at the Tiger 19-yard line. Sandlin, the quarterback this time. Sandlin keeps it, and he's in trouble. And it's going to be knocked down back at the 30-yard line. Talladega with an injured player, and that is Calhoun. These teams have played hard, but a hot night. First game action for Talladega. They'll pick it up. Munford with the football in command. 4:45 to go in the game, leading 28-9. Second down and 28. Low snap. Little mix up as Johnson is running with it. A little bit sloppy here. Clock continuing to move. Munford with a 28-9 lead. They'll move their record to 1-1. They will play Central Clay County next week at Munford. It'll be Munford's first home game. Fumble on the snap, and recovering it is Tuck. Now we've got another injured player down. It's tough on these big guys, I tell you. 28-9, we'll be back in Mayor Dumas Stadium right after this.
Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our knowledgeable pharmacists are always available for questions about your medications or advice on taking over-the-counter products and supplements. Our friendly staff can assist you in choosing from our full lines of compression hose and medical equipment. And don't forget our gift department. We have a great selection of unique gifts for every occasion. Stop by and see us today. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
WOTM, your home of high school sports in Alabama. Watch WOTM this Thursday at 7 p.m. for the AHSAA High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Ox Foundations. This week's matchup has the Minor Tigers traveling to take on the Jackson Olin Mustangs. Stay with WOTM all season through each week of the playoffs. WOTM is also your new home for all seven of the AHSAA championships, live from Jordan-Hare.
Injured player for Talladega still down. Now they're helping him up. Late football game and getting in the third and fourth quarter. And this looks like it might be a little bit more serious with Watley, the injured player. So we're 3:29 to go. Munford 28, Talladega 9. Fourth down and a cab ride. And Munford will punt it away. And it's going to hit and go in the end zone. And Talladega will have it at their 20-yard line with 3:11 to go in the game, trailing 28-9. They're going to have to air it out in a hurry. A lot of tired young men on the Talladega sideline. Munford, meantime, about to get their first win of the season. And they'll have their hands full next week against Central and Clay County, but that'll be at Munford, to be the home opener for the Lions. So Talladega with the first and 10. Scales looks to throw. He's going to be pressured. Now rolls away, throws on the run, looping pass down the field. It's incomplete. Wanted to get it to DeCorian Wilson. But Scales was flushed out of the pocket and had to throw it on the run. 3:03 to go. The clock stopped with the incompletion. Appreciate Omnia sponsoring high school football. Old Curtis and Son Funeral Home, Stop and Shop Auto Sales, Lori Darlings, Cindy Pennington, Silicaga Glass, and many others. Across the 30 and spinning to the 34-yard line. A nice run by the Tigers, and Lee has come in and done a pretty good job running the football for the Talladega Tigers. Didn't start, but he's gotten a number of carries at the 34, first and 10. Nice run for the Tigers again. And, just give it to Lee, let him go with it. So Cindy Pennington, first down across midfield to the 49-yard line. Janice Lee, the running back. And Lee's got it up the middle. And, at the 39-yard line, Lee was kind of twisted on that play. He fumbled the football, but looks like he's going to be okay. That's a first down. Cindy Pennington, first down for the Talladega Tigers, the 39-yard line. 2:21 to go in the game. Talladega trying to get some more points on the board. What they do here with a first down and 10, they need to get further down the field. Munford to give them the middle of the field. Blitz is coming. And some running room down the field. And so Talladega still plugging away. As Calhoun with the carry this time. Larry Calhoun. He broke a couple of tackles, breaks another one there. And the guy that missed him the first time came back and made the tackle. That's Parker. Under 2 minutes to go in the game. We've got a timeout with Munford leading 28-9. We're back after this timeout.
Don't crack under the pressure of foundation issues. The certified specialists at Ox Foundation Solutions can permanently fix foundation problems at the best price guaranteed. And did you know? Moisture and unsafe air from your crawl space can infiltrate your home, causing health hazards and high utility bills. Ox Foundation Solutions has the best plan to keep your home safe. If you are experiencing any issues with your sidewalks, basement, crawl space, or foundation, get a free estimate from Ox Foundations.
Don't forget, coming up at 10:30 tonight, following the completion of our game, it'll be the Pigskin Roundup with our crew from TV24. And I'll be along with a South Talladega County High School Football Report, WOTM, TV24, TV47, and the Alabama Cable Network, all partnering to bring you high school football across the state of Alabama. First down and 10 for the Tigers. Touchdown. Nice throw and catch. The Corian Wilson on the reception. The throw by Nigel Scales. It is a good looking throw and catch there. Beaten in coverage was Parker. And Talladega back on the board again, 28-15. Minute 47 to go. That was a good drive by the Talladega Tigers. Point after to follow. This is Phillips to attempt the extra point. High snap and running for his life and just throwing it away in desperation is Scales. The two-point conversion doesn't work. And it's 28-15 with a minute 47 to go in this football game. We're with you every Friday night for the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. We'll be announcing our whereabouts for next week, coming up first of the week. A lot of college football started Thursday night and playing tonight. Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, too, on Labor Day weekend. My grandson, Zach, he turned out to be a prognosticator. He picked Munford to beat Talladega, and doggone if they're not doing it. He's 9 years old. I want to learn something from him. So Talladega will kick off, and everybody and their brother and sister and mom and dad are looking for the onside kick. So Munford has their sheer hands people up near the 50-yard line. It's all hands on deck when you trail like this and you got to make something happen on the kickoff. Let's see what happens. Talladega late getting a player on the field. Easily fallen on by the Munford Lions. All they have to do is run out the clock now. 28-15 with a minute 47 to go. Talladega does have three timeouts remaining. And Munford will try to seal the deal here. At Mary Dooner Stadium in Talladega. A long night. Looks like we got a timeout here. So we'll take a quick one as well. Back with Munford leading Talladega 28-15.
Looking for a great pre-owned car or truck? Come visit the Collins family at Stop and Shop Auto Sales. Owned and operated by Bobby and Anderson since 1996, and now with the newest member of the team, George Collins. We specialize in quality trucks from Ford and Chevy and also carry a variety of dependable cars and SUVs. All of our vehicles are professionally serviced and checked for safety and reliability. So come see us today in Sylacauga at 230 West 1st Street or call 256-249-0322.
That's my friends, Bobby and Anderson Collins, The Collins family, man, they've been in the car business forever. This family has. And Bobby was showing me a Mustang that they've had that family forever. And it's a nice looking ride, too. So if you need a previously owned vehicle, you're not going to do any better than Stop and Shop Auto Sales on West 1st Street in Sylacauga. First down for the Lions, leading 28-15 at their own 42-yard line. Smith to the 48. Minute 30 to go. Talladega's got two timeouts left, looks like. Second down and three. Munford's gonna milk all that clock down they can without taking a penalty. Now Tuck will take the snap. Smith off right in. Smith stays in bounds across midfield. Penalty flag is down. I don't know if that's a face mask. But let's see. It's on the Munford sideline. We'll sort things out here with 58 seconds to go in the game. Busy night for the officials. Woo. Personal foul. Here's a face mask. That's 15 yards. Smith has been a real factor in this game tonight for Munford. Corbin Smith, young sophomore. He'll be somebody to deal with as you go through the season. Been the workhorse running the football. He's got it again off right in. He's got running room, first down and more. Stutter step. He's looking for the end zone. And got a nice gain out of that. Down to the 31 seconds to go. Inside the 20-yard line at about the 15. Clock continued to run. They may not snap it again. Munford has come to Mary Duma Stadium in Talladega. And they'll go back just up the road, Highway 21, with a 28-15 win over the Talladega Tigers. Coach Michael Easley and his team well prepared for Talladega. They got the running game going. Talladega hurt themselves with turnovers and penalties. And Munford is the winner tonight over the Talladega Tigers by a score of 28-15. Young Corbin Smith was a mainstay for this Munford team tonight. We'll take a look at some of the highlights of Munford and Talladega tonight. Munford gets on the board early with Parker with a touchdown. And Talladega with an interception. And the Tigers get on the board too. As Scales rolls out and looks and looks and looks and throws across the field. That was intercepted. Sistrunk, the big guy, he runs across midfield. And the Lions score right at the end of the first half and get the two-point conversion as well. And Munford wins this one going away by a score of 28-15. Johnson with another touchdown. And interception here is a poor read. An interception by Johnson. And Johnson played well tonight. Is also here Smith for Munford. Smith had well over 100 yards tonight running the football. Talladega not giving up. They get a touchdown late in the game. That's Wilson. And the final is Munford 28 and Talladega 15. We appreciate you watching high school football on TV 47, TV 24, WOTM, and the Alabama Cable Network. Mary Dugan Stadium, your final again, Munford 28, Talladega 15. This is the Donahue Physical Therapy High School Game of the Week. Don't forget, coming up a little later on tonight, it'll be Pigskin Roundup with our friends at TV 24. I'm Jim and L. Aver for all our crew, TV 47. Have a great Labor Day weekend.